I long to hold you tight, 'cause I'm so lonely.
Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hare for Vermont, that is to say Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. For the past 50 years, I have been a loyal subscriber of the most amazing magazine called Billboard. Hideously expensive, but absolutely indispensable if you happen to like pop music. And as one who likes pops, classics, jazz, in between everything else, I'm a sucker for this paper. This is what the magazine looked like in the 50s. And in the 50s, and incidentally, this is what it looks like today. In the 50s, an article broke in Billboard concerning a young man called Barry Gordy, who had created, on the strength of a private family loan, a tiny little label called Tamla. Tamla, in turn, rapidly became Motown, and then finally Gordy. The three together became a powerhouse in American R&B. And it was spearheaded by two people, Barry and a wonderful character called Barney Ales, who must have been the only white employee in the entire organization. But they needed that because in the 50s, they couldn't sell their product simply because of their color. This was a different era. This was a different period. How were they going to crack a market, even with the best music in the biz, without having somebody guide them? Barney Ales, who's still very much with us, as is Barry Gordy, has come up with a book recording the extraordinary history of this magical musical label. And it is called, simply, Motown, The Sound of Young America. It is written by, of course, Barney Ales, but it's also written in conjunction with two other people. The first is Adam White, who was the editor of Billboard for almost a decade and is now a gentleman of a certain age like me as well. But the third person is Andrew Loog Oldham, who was none other than the Rolling Stones manager from day one. He is a legend in his time, as indeed was the group that he managed. But all to say that these three people, spending years to do it, have produced a book which is a Bible. Now, if you think of Motown, and you think of Tamla, and to a lesser extent, Gordy, who do you think of? You think of the Temps, you think of the Four Tops, you think of Diana Ross, you think of the Supremes, you think of David Ruffin, you think of all sorts of groups, and I can run them off. Martha and the Vandellas, Mary Wells, the Marvelettes, the Jackson Five, Gladys Knight and the Pips, Edwin Starr, Eddie Holland, and so on. Eddie Holland, incidentally, being one third of the trio Holland, Dozier, Holland, who were responsible for writing dozens of their hits. The one group that is not singled out for special treatment is the amazing Backup Boys, a group called the Funk Brothers. And for anybody of a certain age like me, who lives in Canada and indeed in the US, you may remember a tour that these wonderful old boys did about a decade ago, where they played their own music, not with the singers that they had backed, but on their own, on a stage, to packed houses. This book is absolutely definitive, and I've waited for it for decades. It covers in the entirety this amazing history, and you can see not only the discs but a catalogue raisonné of what they put out, an account of how the label started, and for each and every artist a listing of their records. It is absolutely wonderful. It's now out in hardcover and paperback, itself unusual. But if you wish to get a really strong dose of R&B, Tamla, Motown, and this guiding light, Berry Gordy, go no further than this Bible. It's a whopper, and it's worth every dime. And on that very musical note, good evening.